this is the Mate 20 line. Now when it comes to design, this is basically every single 2018 phone out there. We get the notch, we get the chin, we get the glass back that doesn't add any function like wireless charging, though I'm happy to say that it does retain the headphone jack, which is something in 2018 that is being removed more and more, which I'm not a fan of. In terms of design though, if we look past that, it is really a well-designed phone. It looks sophisticated, especially in this black version, and the lines on the back, like we've seen on the Mate 10 Porsche version, really do look good. I like the way they have done the camera setup as well, though it does protrude quite a bit, meaning it collects dust like there's no tomorrow. Apart from that though, it is also quite a slippery phone and you don't get a case with it, so you do need to get a case for it. So let's see what the Mate 20 Lite has to offer. So the Huawei Mate 20 Lite features a 6.3 inch IPS LCD display with a full HD plus resolution. Its CPU is a Kirin 710 and you can get it in either 4 or 6 GB of RAM. Internal memory is 64 GB, but you can expand that via the micro SD slot, which is supported up to 256 GB. And then of course we have their own skin on top of Android 8.1. And then to keep that all powered, we have a 3750 mAh battery. And with this battery size, we easily get it through the day and even a bit more. Overall, the performance is solid, it runs smooth and it performs well from basic tests to some games of course. And I haven't experienced any lag, when the battery isn't too low. Now I noticed that sometimes when it drops below 5%, I do have some lag and it does tend to slow down quite a bit. Now this is probably a failsafe to make sure that your phone lasts as long as it can, so you can charge it up before it's empty. Now of course they have their own skin on Android 8.1 and it's something you either like or don't, and there are people out there who really like it, but there are people out there who really prefer the clean Google experience. For myself, I'm not really a fan, but it works fine apart from the icons feeling really large for some reason. It basically looks a bit cluttered to me. And like I said at the beginning, we have to give some credit to Huawei here, which is honestly a bit sad to say, but this Huawei Mate 20 Lite retains the headphone jack, and that in itself is beginning to be more and more of a selling point. And then we get to the display, and we know I'm not a fan of the notch, but the display itself looks fine overall, but it doesn't get as bright as some others out there, and while you can hide the notch, it is still an LCD panel, so you will notice it is there. But enjoying videos and games should be fine on a device like this. But with that being said, we are only getting audio from the bottom facing speaker, so no dual speaker setup here, and it does lack some bass, which depending on the content can hurt the audio experience for me, though it does get pretty loud. So then we get to the part which I wasn't too kind about on the previous Lite version, being the Huawei P20 Lite, and that is its camera. So how does the Mate 20 Lite perform? Well, let's start with its hardware here. We have two cameras, though like I said, the second camera is there to capture the depth, which means it only works on people and not on objects, which is really a shame. Though it allows for some, well, very familiar things from a different brand, which allows for a complete black background, but also a light source that you can move freely around. Though to be fair, it doesn't work that well, and the light itself just looks odd when you move it around over your face. So the main camera is a 20 megapixel camera with a 1.8 aperture, and overall pictures have a good quality. It also features AI like, well, most of the phones these days. But pictures that have AI on can have way too much saturation, especially when you look at grass or trees. The good thing however is that you can toggle that AI mode on or off after you have taken the picture. So the camera itself can create some really good shots with a decent dynamic range, sometimes even impressive for the price. But when it comes to recording video, the stability is not good. The stability has been better on many other phones that I tried, which is really a shame for a price like this. I'm not saying it's terrible, it's just not as good as I expected for this price. And then we get to low light performance, where again it performs decent, but nothing really impressive, giving you plenty of grain, which is mostly noticeable of course on a bigger display, but on your phone it will look fine. At the end of the day, the Mate 20 is a well performing phone that looks good and has a great battery life, and adds features like face unlock while retaining something useful like the headphone jack. I think the Mate 20 is a good buy, but from all the phones I have tried, I wouldn't place this at the top. So, what is your opinion about the Mate 20 Lite? What do you think of its design, and how do you feel about the notch?
Let me know in the comments below, and if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like, and talk to you guys in the next. Also, I want to give a quick thank you to Tech Gear Talk. He helped me out a bit with the settings for my camera, so thank you. Of course, if you like him, check him out and subscribe to him. I'll leave a link in the description.